गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन ऑफ बृहन्मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ चारुशीला नितिन झंटे फ्रॉम एमपीएस धारावी काला किल्ला एंड आवर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसर इज मिसेस स्नेहलता डुमरे मैडम. आवर नोडल बीट ऑफिसर इज मिस्टर शरद कुराडे सर. नोडल एचएम मिसेस मेरी पुष्पम पॉल and assistant nodal hm is mrs manapriti kaur anand and our cno is mr ratilal kishan.
Good morning teacher.
Good morning
first. Good morning. So first we will start from the thought of the day. So what is today's thought? If you want to be more powerful in life, educate yourself. It's that simple. Then if you want to be more powerful, then it's not necessary that you should have money. Only money. No, only money doesn't matter. We should have knowledge. We should have knowledge. And when we will get knowledge, when we will do studies, when we will educate ourselves, that time we will have knowledge also and money also. So whenever we want to be success in our life, we think that no, we should be successful in our life, then that time we should have enough knowledge also and enough money also. So when you will get knowledge, when you will study right from your school education, you should take enough your school education, then your college education, that will be your college life, and then you will go to job. That time you will come to know the importance of education. When you will do job, that time you will come to know that yes, teacher was telling that we should study, why we should study. That time you will realize. So this is the important thing, and this thought for the day is very much it is teaching us that if you want to be more powerful in life, educate yourself. We should never think that what is this studies, I don't want to do it, I don't want to attend the lectures, I don't want to do homework. No, never think like that. You should always think that we should do studies. What is our homework? We should focus on our studies only, because this is only your age. This is the age that time you can focus on studies, on your education, how you can educate yourself. Think that much only. Don't think other. And then your life will be simple, and you will have knowledge also. Yes, now I'm having knowledge how to gain money, how to do the job. Yes, so
yes.
Always, children, listen carefully that focus only in your studies, because this is your age. Once you grow up, you will not get your school education again. So these are the days you are getting your school education. So educate yourself. Learn many things. Read your new books. Read reference books. You will be smart then. Okay? So we'll move forward. So today I'm going to teach you English. That's poem number 15, Bird Bath. Okay? So first of all, I will give you some introduction about this poem or who has written this poem. So this poem has been written by Eva Lenstein. Eva Lenstein is a lady poet, and many women authors have been given recognition. Means that time when she has written this poem, that time women authors or women writers, women poets, they are not being given recognition, because that time they used to give importance to men. They were used to give importance that what they are doing, what they are writing. But many women authors were not being given recognition. Eva Lenstein was an American poet and writer. So she was not from India. She was from American poet. She is an American poet and writer, especially well known for her children's writing. Mrs. Eva Lenstein used to write only about children. Means, you know, every time poem is not real. poem is not real. It is an imaginary fact. Sometimes when you read poem or you listen poem, that time you think, "Arey, how can this happen?" So that time you come to know that no, every poem is not an real. Sometimes you have to just imagine. Because poets, that they imagine and they write the poem. So that time they think if would like this happen, then what would happen? If this thing is there, then what would happen? Like that they think, every time they think, and sometimes you can say that the poem is real. So now this poet, she used to write only for children's writing. It's not nothing others. She said only about children, small children. She was born in Lafayette, Indiana, on October 12, 1863. She lived there her entire life. She's from America. She has been born in Lafayette, Indiana, on October 12, 1863. There only she lived for her entire life. She has never migrated from here and there. Her entire life was there only. This was some information about a poet. Now let's see what is the poem. Now children, you can see here one picture for bird. What that bird is doing?
Pathing.
The bird is just sitting. Okay. And what is that down? That down is water. Yes. So he's just sitting in water. Yes. Now, if you imagine why this bird is sitting in this water, or what that bird is doing there. So that time we can recognize maybe the bird is enjoying the water as we bath every day. Okay. So and we very clean,
okay,
in every morning we bath and we are clean. So birds also think like that only, or what? Birds also like to bath in the water. So that he is enjoying, whether he may be feeling hot in the summer and then he has saw the water is there in the small pond, and then he sat down in that water and he is also feeling very cool now. We also do sometimes, no? Then maybe the bird is thinking that if we are feeling hot now, then let's go in the water in that small pond, and just I will also be happy and I will also feel cool. So that's why I have shown this picture to you. You see, birds are also taking bath. They also like to take bath. But the thing is that they can't speak. They can't live like human beings. Okay. Wherever they can find the water, they drink the water and they search for the food here and there. And just if they feel that there is some water in the pond, so let's take a bath or play in the water. They are having feathers. So they are doing their feathers up and down and splashing over there in the water. See here also, what you can see?
Birds.
There is a group of birds and they are playing in the water.
Yes.
They are just taking, they are just enjoying in the water. They also want to enjoy like you people. You also enjoy in the water when you go to resort for your picnic, when your school picnic goes, or when your family picnic goes. You also enjoy in the water with your friends. Yes or no, students?
Yes, we enjoy. Yes, sir. Sorry, yes,
we enjoy. So these birds also, whether they cannot speak, but they also want to enjoy with their friends. So you can see there is a group of the birds, and they all together, they are playing and they are also enjoying. They don't have hands, but they are taking their feathers up and down. They are served. Let's move forward. So this is our poem. First, I will recite this poem completely, and then we will go to the explanation stanza by stanza. Okay? So first, I will recite this poem.
Please read it, Lakshmi Mishra.
Can I read?
No, I will only recite this poem and then afterwards, afterwards I will explain first explanation part. Let me complete. That time I will tell you, okay? In our garden, we have made such a pretty little pool, lined with pebbles neatly laid, filled with water clean and cool. When the sun shines warm and high, robins cluster round its brink. Never one comes flying by, but will flutter down to drink. Then they splash and splash and splash, spattering little flowers bright, all around till off they flash, singing sweetly their delight. So very short and simple poem is this. Now, you can see the pictures also, na?
Yes.
Yes, miss.
Yes, you can see all these pictures. Yes. Now, we will go stanza by stanza explanation. Now, what this poet is, we have made such a pretty little pool. Now, what that poet is saying, that poet...
Miss, your voice is not coming.
Oh, Evelyn.
Is saying that in our garden, where my garden is there, in our garden, what that poet is saying, in my garden...
Miss, your voice is not coming.
So, this is our first stanza. We will explain... In our garden, we have made such a pretty little pool, lined with pebbles neatly laid, filled with water clean and cool. Now, what that poetess is telling? What that poetess is telling?
Evelyn said, our garden.
Evelyn, what she is telling? In my garden, I have made a pretty little pool. In that pool, it is very pretty and beautiful and lined with pebbles neatly laid. Lined with pebbles means I have arranged correctly that pebbles. Now, what is pebbles? They are the small stones.
Small stones.
Neatly laid. As you can see, next to the stanza, there is one picture. In that picture, you can see that white color. What are these? What, there are stones, and that small stones are known as pebbles. They are so soft, and that stones, they have lined properly to the edges of the pool. Means the pool is round in shape, and the stones are also arranged in round properly. Means it is not messy. We can see when we see ki wow, now it is looking very beautiful. It is looking very nice. Like that we can see, na? See how pretty and presentable. Filled with water, clean and cool. And the most important thing of that pool is the water which is filled over there is very much clean and cool also. Means the water is not dirty over there. Nothing dirtiness is there in that water. No bad smell is there. The water which they have filled over there is very clean and cool. So we can see that by seeing this picture only, we can say ki very nice. This pool has been arranged by this Evelyn. It's looking very nice because of the small stones. That small stones are known as pebbles. Okay. Now let's move forward to the second stanza. When the sun shines warm and high, robin cluster around its brink. Now what happens? When the sun shines warm and high, means when the sun starts giving in the afternoon, when the sun shines warm and high, when the morning is not there, in the afternoon time, this time is of afternoon time, robins cluster around its brink. Means robins are the birds over there. That time what happened? This robin make their group. And when they make their group, they just come and sit in the pool around its brink. Brink means you can tell the edge of the pool. The edge of the pool. In the second picture, you can see how they sit in the edge of the pool. Yes, by making their group, they are sitting in the edge of the pool. Never one comes flying by, but will flutter down to bring. Then what happens? Never one comes flying by. That time they just sit over there and they just enjoy the water. They just enjoy the water and but will flutter down to drink. Flutter means they will just bend down in the pool and they will drink over there. What they will drink? That water. And they will bath over there only and they will just play. Okay. One picture I will show you. See. See, this is the picture. How you can see the sun shines warm and high. Means in the time of afternoon. In the time of afternoon, what happens? See this robin cluster around its spring. Means a robin, he is taking the group. Means you can see, you can say the group of the birds, they just, one bird never come to play in the water. Means, if you can see, rarely you can see that one, that at only one bird is coming over there in the pool and he is drinking or taking bath, but always they have a group. And when they have a group, they are just coming in their unity and then they just sit in the edge of the pool. You can see how they are sitting, they drink over there and they just stay, sit there only for 5 to 10 minutes and they make themselves cool and then just they enjoy. See in this picture, you can see how they enjoy. Yes, children?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, na? They are enjoying, na?
Yeah. Okay.
Then we will move forward to the next stanza. Then they splash and splash and splash. Means just they are splashing, splashing and splashing. Now, what is the meaning of splashing? What they are doing in the water? They don't have hands, children. They have feathers. So what they are doing? Just moving their feathers up and down, up and down, up and down. Spattering little showers bright all around till off they flash. Means now they are just moving their... Now they're just moving their feathers up and down, up and down, up and down. And just they don't think of the other things that what they are going to do. But in the group, when they drink the water in the group, that time they just splash, splash and splash. And after splashing, they just drink the water and singing sweetly their delight. Means what they are doing... Means what they are doing, just singing the song. Means when they drink water, they feel very happy and cool. And that time what they do, singing sweetly, they are delight. Now you can see in this picture, when they splash, see one bird's feather is up and one bird feather is down and one is fluttering down to drink water. You can see over there. And then in the next picture, you can see that the bird is just singing a song. Means he is happy now. That bird is happy now by drinking water, by taking bath, by playing in the water. He is very much happy and he is feeling very nice and healthy now. Means, for example, I can give you one example over here that... when we are very much tired, okay, children, then we are very much tired and we are feeling uneasy and you are feeling hot also. That time if you take a bath and when you take a bath, you play sometime in the water and then when you come after bath, that time how you feel, students? That time you feel ki now, yes, I'm feeling very nice now. Why is it so? Because when we take a bath, when we play in the water, that time we feel very much happy. And we feel, see, Baba, now it is very nice. We are feeling very nice and our mood also changes. So in this poem, that only the poet, she wants to tell that I have made a garden. In that garden, I have made a pretty little pool. A pretty little pool and lined with pebbles. Means she has decorated that pool with small stones, with pebbles and with a clean and cool water. I have put over there. And then what happens in the afternoon? When the sun shines warm, means that is in the afternoon time, what happens? Robin takes his group. means Robin cluster means what he do, he makes a group of his of there, and then they come over here in that pretty pool and they lay down and flutter down to drink the water, and they drink the water how much they required. After drinking, they splash and splash and splash over there, means they are just playing in the water with their friends. And then when they thinking now it's okay for me, I am very cool now, that time they go from there and just sing sweetly, hey baba, now I am very much happy, my mood is also very much happy now, I don't want anything, I just want to sing a song. Okay children, so this was our poem. So now we will see what was there in the poem. In the poem, the poet elaborated the little pool that she has made in her garden, that was neatly laid with pebbles and cold and clean water. Robins arrive when the day was warm, and she flutters to drink, and then later started to bath in the mini pool. Means this is just what is the poem. In short, I have given you the summary of the poem. This is the summary of the poem. So I hope children you have understood now. So now let's move forward to the question and answers.
Yes.
You can take a screenshot also. Okay, children. Yes. And you can write in your notebook.
Yes, I take it.
First question, where did the robins take a bath? Now, bath. The answer of this question is the in the pretty little pool in the garden. So, where the robins have taken a bath? The robins have taken a bath in the pretty little pool in the garden.
Because it was lined with pebbles.
Yes. Second question is, why did the poet call the pool pretty? Now, why the pool was pretty? Now, answer for this question is, the poet called the pool pretty because it was lined with pebbles that were neatly laid and filled with clean and cool water. Let's move forward. You can take screenshot of this also, students, and you can write. Now, let's move forward for question number 3. When did the robins come to the pool?
The robin come to the pool when the sun shine height set in the sky.
Very good. Now let's move forward for the 4th question. What did the robins do in the pool?
Say and robins drink and clean and cool water of the pool.
Of the pool.
Take a screenshot, means you can write this in your notebook.
Yes.
Last but not the least, how do you know that the robin felt happy after playing in the pool?
Answer.
We know that the robin felt happy after playing in the pool because they sing sweetly in delight.
We can say that the robins were happy. They were just happy because they were singing sweetly. And when we sing a song, when we are in the happy mood, when our mood is happy, that time only we sing the songs. Yes, that okay. Yes. Now, this is the poem, children. And from this poem, I want you. Tell me the rhyming words from the poem. Now just tell me the rhyming words.
Made.
Yes.
Made.
Very
pool,
good.
Cool.
Pool cool. Very good.
Hi, bye.
Hi. Hi, bye.
Okay. Drink.
Bring drink. Very good.
Splash, splash.
Splash and splash. Okay. Now see, what were our rhyming words? Laid, made, pool, cool, drink, brink, splash, splash. Okay, children? So these were the rhyming words. I hope, have you understood the poem?
Yes. I read it, Lakshmi Mishra.
Okay,
Read.
Once in our garden we have met. In our garden we have met such a pretty little pool, laden with pebbles neatly laid, filled with water clean and blue, cool. When the sun shines warm and high, robin cluster round its spring, never one comes flying by, but will flutter down to drink. Then they splash and splash, splashing little sour sprite all around daily of the flash, sighing in with their little delight.
Yes, very good. Nice, we have read the poem. Now just we will move forward to our homework. Now what is your homework?
Yes.
Meanings. Okay. So now I will read line. Now what is the meaning of line? Present in large numbers along the edges or sides of something. Means it is present in large numbers. In that poem you can see pebbles. Means small stones are present in large numbers and it was arranged properly. Okay. Now pebbles. What is pebbles? Small smooth stones found on beaches or at the bottom of rivers. As I told you, pebbles are small smooth stones. That stones are not hard. I think these pebbles are used in the fish tank also, sometimes for decorating. Colorful pebbles are there in the fish tank also, we use for decorating. And it is found in the beaches or at the bottoms of the rivers. Now, what is cluster? Cluster is to form a small close group. What is cluster? To form a small close group. Brink. What is brink? Brink means edge. Spattering. Scattering in small drops. Means if we are moving, our hand in the water. Some little drops come up now from the water. So when the birds splash their wings, what happens? The water drops comes up. That is. So that water drops are scattering over here and there. Flash means go quickly.
Go quick.
Yes, children, take a screenshot of this.
Miss, I take it.
Yes, everyone take this screenshot and you have to write this 2 times in your English notebook and learn and write this. Okay?
Yes. Miss, I take it, Lakshmi Mishra. Bye, me.
Stay safe.
Stay safe.